Today is my 23rd solo return. Just wanted to have a head start on taking care of myself today and really showing up for myself today. So I was like, let me really get grounded. I wrote down my dream from the night before, and then I actually wrote a little spoken word, and I would like to share it with you guys with a little reflection of the past year. This is what I've learned from year 22. The year of self-mastery taught me that the most massive of hurt can be used to remember who you are, not to dwell in the pain or live there all the same, but to allow yourself the peace of release and putting your mind at ease. To feel so you can heal, to know you're worthy of reveal, to take your time no matter if the world's on a tight schedule, you are the center of your world. And love lives within you. You decide to let it sing, and with that knowledge, what you will do. So do not be afraid or think it always strong to hide your hurt and pain because it once made you feel wrong. Because what you've grown through has also turned your heart into gold. 22 taught me the magic life makes of us if we only allow ourselves to break an outdated mold. And behold, all along, change was nothing to fear. Because you keep on rearranging, and yet your truest self is always right here. And with that, your sensitivity was never too much. So be gentle with your words and be soft with your touch. Be fierce when you feel it and allow yourself to be enraged when those inevitable stuck points come up right before another turning of a page. And now that I'm leaving behind 22, I look forward to the new things I'll learn and do. And the lessons I may circle back to again, and I'll know to love and accept the person that I was then. Because she lives and grows with me every day, and I allow her the space to be, to shed, to laugh, to heal, to forgive, to listen, to dance, to sing, to let her soul ring, to play, to nurture, to explore, to be brave, to express her delights and pains, and to forever know she is more than allowed to continue to change. Thank you, year 22. On to the next. Thank you for listening.
Why is that genuinely fun?
Hello. Hello, how are you? How are you? Oh, that's really mature. Say exactly what I said. This is my outfit for right now. Of course, I have my carrier pants on. If you couldn't tell by now, they are literally my favorite pants. Is there anything you would like to say to the vlog?
My girl is grown, beautiful, stunning, intelligent, amazing, talented, talented, talented. I'm very grateful for my Leo fashionista, Care Bear, Hello Kitty, loving, beautiful sister. 23 today, grown as hell, but she's been grown since she was 13, going on 30. And yeah.
I have my coffee and I'm about to get ready for the day, and then we're gonna go get some donuts. I've never tried these donuts before, and they're about to be amazing. And then I think we're going to just vibe and see where the day takes us.
I just seen two pretty bad. Bye. Stand up for yourself. Goodness gracious.
Sticks to his love it if you made it guns of evoking despair via description.
This was a very successful birthday.
I'm thankful for you, my darling sister.
Ditto. This was a great birthday. Tomorrow we're gonna hit up the beach.
I'm currently in line at the DMV, which is an adventure in and of itself. I'll keep you guys updated on how it's going, but so far, I've been here for 30 minutes. I'm finally leaving the DMV, and...
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
Literally, I freaking get my number finally called just so that I can pay for my registration. And my car doesn't work because my bank is charging it is fried. So I have to lose my spot in line and then I have to stand there. I call my bank and I'm number 21. And it actually goes by faster than I thought. That was the number 8 pretty soon. And then they finally answered and she was like, oh, let me talk to so-and-so, the people who work with the card services and just check whatever. I was like, no, it's not fraud, it's me. But she takes like a couple minutes. I'm like, girl! She answers, she's like, okay, it should be good to go now. Then I go to a different girl before I go back to the girl for my registration because she told me to go to her to get my license. And she's like, you don't have your birth certificate, which I already knew. That's why I ordered a new one. I was like, okay, whatever, that's an L. So then I go back to the other lady for my registration. I'm like, okay, at least I can get my registration today. And then I freaking go to the girl for the registration and my Apple Pay declines. I'm like, I literally will cry right here, right now. If I have to get back out of line and I have to call my bank again, I'm like, okay, no, I can't do this. So I pull my card, I swipe it, and finally, it worked. My bank finally took that fraudulent thing off. I was like, I'm so sorry. Like, thank you for being patient with me. She said something smart. I was like, don't be rude to me. I'm trying to be nice. I was trying to apologize for the inconvenience. Thank you for listening to my little story time about the DMV. I'm going to go about my day and have a fabulous day.